Welcome from Chem Help ASAP. We've said hybridization is used to predict bond angles and geometries. Now let's see what kind of bond angles and geometries we encounter with hybridized atoms. So on the screen, we have this very sloppy table. And across the top, we have columns that are represented by A. And remember, A is the number of attached atoms. And the rows going down are our types of hybridization. So we're going to populate this table. So when we have two attached atoms, we have to be at least sp hybridized. And if we are sp hybridized, the geometry is going to be linear with a bond angle of 180 degrees. Now, as we go across the table, we can't have three attached atoms and be sp hybridized. That doesn't work in our formula. We need at least as many hybrids as we have attached atoms. So this is not applicable, and the same is true for four attached atoms. Now let's go to sp2. If we have an sp2 hybridized atom with two attached atoms, that will mean we have a lone pair getting a hybrid as well. Then we're going to have a bent molecule with a bond angle of 120 degrees. If we have three attached atoms in sp2 hybridization, we are going to be trigonal planar for our geometry. And again, we will still have 120 degree bond angles. If we have four attached atoms, we will not be sp2 hybridized because sp2 only gives us three hybrids. We need at least four if we have four attached atoms. So this is not applicable. Finally, if we have two attached atoms and our molecule is sp3 hybridized, and we'll see examples of those, we would say that geometry is bent and the bond angle is 109.5. If we have three attached atoms and we're sp3 hybridized, this will be trigonal pyramidal, and we will have bond angles of approximately 109.5. And let's put degree signs on there. And then finally, if we have four attached atoms and we're sp3 hybridized, our geometry will be tetrahedral, and 109.5 approximately will be our bond angle. Now, as you see, the bond angle as we go across this row stays constant. So what determines bond angle? Well, it's the hybridization. The hybridization alone determines the bond angle. What determines the geometry? The geometry is about both hybridization and the number of attached atoms. We need to know both of those items to determine the geometry, because it can change linear, bent, trigonal planar, trigonal pyramidal, you name it. So, if we know the hybridization, we know what the bond angle will be. In order to know the geometry, we need to know both the hybridization and the number of attached atoms for our particular atom.